Thomas, Rich, first of all, just wanted to thank you both for being here. So obviously, we're here today to talk about the orb, this device that's right next to us. And there's a lot of excitement around the new orb. But I think before we go into that, it's nice to take a step back and just sort of, you know, for someone who might not know, Rich, maybe you could talk about what is the orb and what role does it play in the world network?
Yeah, sure, John. So the orb is our device that we use to prove humanness and uniqueness and enable someone to get a world ID.
Starting sort of from the technical perspective, Rich, you know, what are some of the changes of this new orb and why are they exciting?
Yeah, John, so there's a number of changes. In fact, the latest orb is designed from the ground up with manufacturability in mind. So we are able to scale the orb to much higher numbers than we ever have previously. Secondly, you know, we're using the latest NVIDIA Jetson processor that runs all of our AI models on device. And there's a number of other improvements such as improved cameras as well as fully removable memory. So anyone can audit the source code that's running on the orb versus our open source code that we publish.
You know, I think we've talked about and we've heard about these operational models, these new operational models that are going to be rolling out. Can you talk a little bit about what those are and what users can expect?
So we're going to have orbs operating in a few different models that we haven't seen before. So firstly, we'll keep the assisted versions. If you want help verifying, much like that exists today, you can go to fixed locations and there'll be people that are staffing it will help you verify. We also have kind of a premier version of that. We're calling our flagship locations where we will have people there to assist you. And we've actually just opened a couple locations, one in Buenos Aires and one in Mexico City. And we'll be opening a few more in key locations around the world in the coming months.
Great.
We also have a self-serve model, which is new to the orb. So it's gonna allow orbs to be placed within another retailer. So imagine the lobby of a coffee shop might have an orb and you can discover the orb and the project through noticing it in your local coffee shop and verify yourself if you wish. And then lastly, we're gonna have orbs on demand. So if you just don't wanna go and find an orb, you can request that one comes to you and verify you wherever you are.
One of the most important aspects is that you look at the orb when you are getting verified. So the question is like, how do you create something which is friendly? How do you create something which is very simply understood? One of the goals with this project is obviously to reach everybody in the world. So how do you create an object which then needs to look at you and you invite people to look at the object instead? So we have a shroud, as we call it. This is the inner piece here. And I could probably see if this works live here if I turn this on. And as you can see now, it's lightening up on the inside, slowly pulsating. This is when the users should look right in this area.
Yeah.
And as you can see, the mirror, which is now round, it's moving. And in the very start of this, you can actually see yourself and see your own face. And now it's going to the position where it's scanning the eyes, and now it's finished. So it's quite sort of descriptive, yet gentle and sort of engaging.
And in terms of the new orb, let's start with you, Rich. What's the thing that excites you most about the new orb and sort of what it entails for the world network?
Yeah, so the new orb, because it was designed from the ground up really with manufacturability and scale in mind, is really gonna just enable us to make many more of these than we've had out there in the world to date. So we'll be initially doubling our production capacity, but then increasing it even more from there with these new models, but also with new assembly partners that we're gonna be working with and ultimately enabling this decentralized manufacturing model that we ultimately want to get to. If you look at where orbs are today in the world, they're mostly concentrated in high population density areas, like mostly capital city centers. And I think with some of these new operational models, we're really gonna be able to distribute orbs to a much greater extent throughout the countries we operate. So we'll expect to see more of these out in the world in high volume starting early next year in 2025.